I ask the Holy Spirit what to do. I say, tell me what to do. The Holy Spirit says, tape. I said, that's all I do. I said, don't you have something else I can do? Apparently not right now, just tape. Do more taping. Well, I said, maybe the people are tired of watching all these videos. And the Holy Spirit says, you never know. Maybe there's someone out there that's maybe it's being a benefit somehow. Maybe these ideas are filtering down somehow. I said, well, it's possible, yeah. But what can we possibly say we haven't already said before? Well, the Holy Spirit keeps surprising us, doesn't it? Surprise us with a prayer this morning. I abide with the light. I live as the light. I have no needs. And you can even add a third part to it, which is, I abide with the light. I live as the light. I am the light. I have no needs. The first part is, I abide with the light. That is the vision of oneness. That's the first step that we're aiming for. We see the light of oneness, the light of the totality, which includes all of the unmanifest. Something manifest is one with the unmanifest, unmanifesting of it too. See, God is always complete in every respect. So something that's manifest is also the totality of what is not manifest. That's also present. So the totality of the unmanifest is omnipresent. No matter what appears, no matter what appears. It's totally steady. It's totally steady. The totality of the unmanifest is a completely calm, peaceful position to be in. So that's the vision of oneness. The second part is, I live as the light. That is, as we abide with the light, we allow the light to be our life, to be our life. The light is our life. I live as the light, and that has no needs. So somehow the light takes care of all what we perceive as needs, takes care of everything. The third part, which would be, I am the light, is transcends what we can really focus on here. That would be reality, full acceptance of reality as it is. I am the light. I am the light. So we're going for, I abide with the light. I live as the light. I have no needs. So giving out this prayer to the world is, I feel very bit tense and nervous and jittery, and for some reason just have to calm down here. Very warm today, very warm here. At some point, it seems that there's a necessary step, is to throw yourself on the mercy of the light. Surrender to the light, as it were. Surrender the notion that there's something other than the light is what we're surrendering. Now, we're so used to supposedly succeeding with this something other than the light that we're afraid to let it go, but actually, there has never been anything other than the light. And we've just kind of had this very bizarre situation called the world, called bodies, called existence, struggling, but at some point we can throw ourselves upon the mercy of the light, surrender to the light. This is what I feel is coming. Surrender to the light. Surrender your notion that there's anything other than the light. then we're living in the light, living as the light. Abiding with the light, living as the light, having no needs. So we can talk about this, look at this, and introduce this notion of surrendering to the light, surrendering to the light. I feel like this is what I want to do. Now, there's resistance to it. So, and a goal like such as this, which is really only the only goal there is, it certainly has a continuity fear attached to it, right? So we have to evaporate that continuity fear by looking at it and saying, yeah, this is what I'm going to do, trying to normalize it as much as possible. I surrender to the light. I surrender to the light, absolutely. I surrender that there is any notion that there's something other than the light. I surrender any notion that there's anything other than the light, than the one light. Of course, we believe our life is built on something other than the light. So as we seem to be jumping into an abyss, or we'll be willing to die. So this is what Maharaj says. He said, I've died already. When he is asked, how do you view your own death when your body dies? How do you view that? He says, what do you mean? I've died. I've already died. You don't want me to die again, do you? I don't have to die again. Really? Come on. The death is the surrendering of the notion there's anything other than the light. And we think our life has been with something other than the light. It's not true. So we think we're surrendering our life, but Jesus said, he who would lose his life would gain it, all right? And he who would hold on to his life would lose it, so to speak. So by surrendering our any notion that there's anything other than the one light, that's how we become aware that we are the light. We are the light. Everything is the light. Come across someone who's done that is a wonderful thing. I've never come across anyone here in the world personally. When I was here, you know, one-to-one, I didn't come across anyone. But there have been those in the world who have surrendered to the light. And there probably are some in this world who have done it. I don't know. I don't know of any in particular, actually. But that's no reason not to do it. For some reason, maybe they're just, I mean, there's so many people in the world. Who's to say there aren't quite a few here and there? But for some reason, I haven't come across them. It doesn't really matter. That's what we really need. That's what we really need. So certainly that has to be our aim. If we understand the problem, our aim is the remedy. So understanding how big the problem is helps out a lot. It really does. In a previous video, I pointed out the setup, how this we've all been set up. We've been set up incredibly cleverly. And so this is a huge problem. A huge problem. I feel in my own life I've been set up so badly to take the fall, to be the scapegoat, to be the bad guy, you know. All this stuff, it's a setup, for sure. So it seems like, wow, there's no remedy. This is a horrible, you know, trap that's been set. Well, there is one remedy, and that is surrender to the light. Give up any notion that there's anything other than the light. And I feel confident that that is sufficient to free us from this trap. So once we know how bad the trap is, then we can start talking about what the remedy is. Where Whereas if we see it differently, we say, oh, it's not so bad. Then we think, well, why do I need to surrender to the light like that? That's an extreme measure. You know, it's the only measure that really works. But we see it as too extreme if we think our problem, we just have a little problem, you know, we just work it out and everything's fine. And no, we don't have just a little problem. We have this extreme issue, which is ultimately the expression of the continuity fear, which is incredibly severe. Continuity fear can be incredibly severe and cause us to act in ways that seem to be just amazingly foolish. I mean, yet be extremely dedicated to that folly, extremely dedicated to setting ourselves up to justify deeper delusion, deeper belief in definition and form. The form is life, definition in the life, that reality can be defined. We just get more and more and more into delusion that there's some other light, different light other than the one light. And so I would say surrender to the light is the way to go. Surrender to the light is the way to go. And I've heard this throughout my life, that the great teachers say this is the way to go. But I didn't quite understand what they're talking about, because I didn't realize just how incredibly severe the continuity problem is, and how this gets acted out in ways that are truly, we set ourselves up, constantly setting ourselves up. So it seems as though we have no way out. No way out. We feel trapped. Really trapped. You know, people get suicidal because they say, I can't get out of this situation. No matter what I do, I look bad. I look wrong. Just like, wow, how in the world have I managed to set myself up so badly? Well, remember, it's the light that has set us up because we asked it to. And so, of course, the light has done an incredibly great job at this. We ask the light to set it up so it seems like there's another light, a light of process, okay? A separate light. And so we feel trapped by this so-called separate light. We can't get free of it. It has its own logic, its own way of functioning, which is horrible. Isn't it horrible? So tricky and sly and clever and deceitful and forgetful and selective memory and distortions and just this whole horrible mess of deceitfulness. And we think that's coming from a separate light. No, it's not. It's not. It's all coming from the one light. Just one, there's just one light. We ask the light to do this. So being the light, being the loyal light, it is. It has presented this appearance as if there is a separate light that is treacherous, that is deceitful, that sets us up to fail, you know, all this stuff. So indeed, it does seem as if we are trapped beyond our comprehension. But remember, the light is infinitely creative. So this is just evidence that it is the one light. It's very strong evidence. Say, hey, only the one light could be doing, making me feel like so hopelessly trapped, right? Yeah, that's right. And in fact, our continuation with it and struggling and say, no, I can make this work somehow, is actually our belief that it is a separate light. Because if we thought it was truly the one light that was setting us up, we'd realize, hey, there's nothing I can do. I have to surrender to the light and say, hey, there's only one light, not two. And be repentant and say, let's choose a new idea instead of trying to be greater than God. Let's be reconciled unto God. So our very effort to say that we can make it without surrendering to the light is our expression of our belief that there is a separate light, and that's what we're dealing with. Because we think that separate light, we think we're in control, that we can get to do what we want, and it's just a matter of being clever enough and working hard enough at it, etc. But if it truly is the one light, then we know its creativity is boundless, is effortless. It never gets tired. It never sleeps. Its creativity is boundless, and its capacity to give us the appearance that we're trapped in another light is not anything that we can overcome. It's not anything that can be overcome. So in a very paradoxical way, the more stuck you feel, the closer you are to recognizing, hey, this must be the one light that's doing this, not any separate light at all. And you see the ones that seem to be doing well in the world, etc., they think they're working with a separate light. And so, you know, they haven't yet felt the full teeth of this delusion, self-deception we asked for. But when you try to get free of it, when you really try to dominate this separate light, supposedly separate light situation, to truly get on top of it, that's when you find out that you can't, that you cannot. And then you say, wow, what am I up against here? I seem to be up against an intractable foe. Well, that intractable foe is actually the one light, because we asked it to be an intractable foe, to play the role of intractable foe. We asked it to play the role of a separate light, even though it isn't. So, being really stuck is actually a good thing if you can see it in this way. You say, hey, it must be the one light that is playing this trick on me, because I must have asked it to. Why would it do this unless I asked it to? That makes sense, right? Well, then I can ask it not to, right? So all I need to do is say, I'm going to surrender. I've decided to surrender this notion that there's anything other than the one light. And that's called surrendering to the light. Surrendering to the light. Surrendering the notion. And I would say that is sufficient remedy for the problems that we have. This is the rebirth. Jesus says you have to be born again, you know, the King of Heaven. This is the rebirth. Surrendering to the light is the rebirth. But it's interesting, birth is actually giving up the notion of birth. It's the end of your birth. It's the end of the notion that there's birth, some birth of a separate light, that somehow your matter or form or definition, something other than the light. You're giving up your birth. The rebirth is to give up your birth. And, of course, I thank all the teachers that have come before. We must always be cognizant of this. This particular insight came from Punjaji. And I heard that and I said, wow. See, a little snippet I just heard, and I said, that is a tremendous perspective there. And then you get other things from other teachers. I mean, I get little snippets from all over, actually. I brought Jesus into this very heavily here. Must be born again, the heir of the kingdom. He who would lose his life would gain it. You see, these are tremendous snippets of teaching. They say, hey, this fits. Absolutely it fits. Because what's happening in the world is this demand that you accept that you have been born of a different light, born of the flesh, born of something other than light. You see? Now, we've never been born. Nobody's ever been born. Give up the notion that we've been born. This is what we must give up. That's called losing your life, dying, as Maharaj says. I've already died. I realized I was never born. I'm not interested in dying again. Give up the notion that you've been born from some separate light. It's not true. And of course, everything is one with the one light. So there's no the light is already born entirely by God. It's inherently always born, always alive, always light. There's no condition where it's not. So we can't say that we've been born. We could say born again is giving up the notion that we were ever born. Give up the notion that we were ever born. It's just a false notion. And people will say, well, then you won't have life. No, I won't have a false notion of some separate life from something other than the light. I won't be burdened with that crazy notion, which is great. I ask the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, can I finally go golfing? It's been such a long time. It's just been a non-stop push. And the Holy Spirit says, no. No golf, no way. Wow. So something is important enough here to say, just stick to it. Gotta stick to it right now. Gotta stick to it right now. We're in the World Cup here, time, right? Well, I guess I should get into that. I'll shy away from that. Let's just keep focusing on what we need to do. Surrender to the light. Surrender to the light. Surrender to the light. Surrender the notion that we were ever born of some other light. And therefore we were never actually born at all. Because we think we've been born out of the light by some other light. You see, and having a life from that other light. No, nothing like that has ever happened. So we've never been born. Never been born. Nothing's ever been born. We're all born free. We're all free of being born. We're a freeborn man. We're freeborn. Just even simpler. We're all freeborn. Free of birth. We're all free birthers. Free of birth. Never having taken birth. And others will say, well, we took birth. Say, no, nobody has. They have the notion that they did. It's just a notion. Some say concept, idea. We use notion is maybe even more to the point. A silly notion. It's like the ocean saying, I've been born, now I've been born as a wave. And now I'm just the wave. No more ocean, I'm the wave now. I said, no, ocean, you weren't born as a wave. The wave is all still one with you. There's just one ocean. All the waves, but the waves are not separate from the ocean. You can't be, ocean cannot be born as a wave. And that's what it is. Light cannot lose its identity as light. Light cannot lose its identity as light. Light cannot lose its identity as light. So if at all possible, I'd certainly like to surrender this foolish notion to the light. Be born again. Realize I was never born. Well, you might say that your mother will say, well, I gave birth to you. I know you were born. Well, your mother wasn't born either. So how can she say she gave birth to you? How can what is not born give birth? It's not possible. If no one's been born, how can we say that anyone's given birth? We think we've given birth to the flesh, but it is not. The flesh is the light. There's only the light. You can't give birth to the light. We're not God. We cannot give birth to the light. It must be Wednesday. Here come the leaf blowers, which are going to be outlawed very soon. In a few more days, actually. At least no more gasoline leaf blowers. So this video has gotten into surrender the notion of birth to the light. Surrender that foolish notion, that silly notion. Surrender to the light. And realize there's only one light. Now intuitively this seems right. Just intuitively I can just feel, hey, this is what I really want to do. Absolutely. The leaf blower gives us a good opportunity to be quiet, doesn't it? So we will continue on with this, and I'll make it short here, and then we'll see, keep taping, and see if we can't keep pushing this, advancing in this way, finding out what the remedy is here. Okay, very great. We'll see how it goes. That's it.